What is going on, guys? Welcome to you once again with some 3D anatomy. Now we're going to be going into the nervous system. All right, I know this looks complicated, but we're going to break it down nice for you guys and get you to just the most important aspects. So first and foremost, we want to divide these up to two sections, the first being the nerves that run through the front of the body and then the nerves that run through the back. Now, the two groups that we are going to be dividing the nerves into are going to be the nerves of the lumbar plexus and then the nerves of the sacral plexus. And true to its name, the lumbar plexus is named thus because it is formed out of nerves that pop out of the lumbar spine and a little bit of thoracic spine. T12, L1, L2, L3, and L4. So, the nerves that pop out of these vertebrae are called the lumbar plexus, or make up the lumbar plexus. So, lumbar plexus, T12 through L4. So, lumbar plexus, T12 through L4. Now, insofar as motor function, we're going to see two key nerves coming out of the lumbar plexus. We're going to see this blue nerve here, the femoral nerve. We heard a lot about the femoral nerve, in particular, it being the innervator of the anterior thigh muscles. And then this blue nerve right here, it's the obturator nerve. And it's called the obturator nerve because it passes through, if you look at it, it passes through this hole here called the obturator foramen. The obturator foramen. So pretty much everything that has to do with as near or passes through this obturator foramen is going to have the name obturator. So in this case, we call this the obturator nerve. This is going to innervate a lot of the medial thigh muscles, as opposed to the femoral nerve, which innervates a lot of the anterior thigh muscles. So you might ask me, what are these other nerves around here? What are these other nerves? Like this turquoise, I think turquoise, aquamarine-ish type nerve is pretty prominent. What are those nerves for? Well, those aren't motor nerves so much as they are sensory nerves. For example, this is called the lateral cutaneous nerve. So maybe in studying the skin, you might have heard the subcutaneous layer. So these are actually nerves that send sensory information from the skin towards the central nervous system. Now, a lot of the cutaneous nerves branch off from other main branch nerves. For example, the femoral nerve actually branches anterior cutaneous branch. Those sensory nerves are branches of the main femoral nerve, and along with that are the specific branches of the femoral nerve to the specific muscles, like the rectus femoris, for example. One other sensory nerve that branches off of the femoral is the, let's see if I can get it, the saphenous nerve. The saphenous nerve, very long nerve that actually continues all the way down to the medial side of the lower leg. So it provides a lot of the sensation that you feel if you take your hand and you start feeling the side of your lower leg, you're able to feel that because of the saphenous nerve. So what do you need to remember there? Well, just remember that you have the lumbar plexus and the sacral plexus. The lumbar plexus is composed of nerves that branch out from T12 of the thoracic spine all the way down to L4 of the lumbar spine. The motor nerves associated with these are the obturator nerve here and the femoral nerve here. Femoral nerve being particularly important because not only does it innervate the muscles of the anterior thigh, but it also has branches of the saphenous nerve and also femoral cutaneous nerve, giving you a lot of sensation from your thigh. Meanwhile, the obturator nerve not only controls medial aspects of the thigh, but it also has sensory branches as well, which allow you to feel your medial thigh. So now we're going to take a look at the sacral plexus. That's L5 to S4, as opposed to the lumbar plexus, which was T12 to L4. We have the sacral plexus, which is L5 to S4. So while the lumbar plexus is primarily responsible for innervation of the front of the leg, with some exceptions such as the posterior femoral nerve, posterior femoral cutaneous nerve found here, which is runs through the back of the leg, but for the most part, the lumbar plexus innervates a lot of the front of the lower limb. The sacral plexus innervates much of the back. So we have several branches that come out of the sacral plexus. First, we have the superior gluteal nerve. Remember the superior gluteal nerve? The superior gluteal nerve innervates which one? The gluteus medius and the gluteus minimus. The gluteus medius and gluteus minimus. And what other muscle does it innervate? Does anyone remember? Connects right here, runs down the side. It is the tensor fasciae lata. So the superior gluteal nerve innervates the gluteus medius and minimus and also the tensor fasciae lata. But you also remember that the gluteus maximus is innervated by the what? Inferior gluteal nerve. And that is not it. That should be right here. The inferior gluteal nerve. So you can remember the gluteus maximus existing right here and inserting down this gluteal tuberosity and running down the linear aspera. You can just imagine it getting innervated, since it's there, getting innervated by this inferior gluteal nerve running here. So all of those muscles from the deep posterior portion of the thigh, if you remember, passing gas on stage gives quiet onlookers, okay, piriformis, gemellus superior, obturator, internus, gemellus inferior, quadratus femoris, obturator, externus. So those are innervated here too, with nerves that branch out from the sacral plexus. And finally, we have the sciatic nerve. And the sciatic nerve is super important because it innervates most of the back of the leg and goes all the way down. So usually if the muscle is in the back of the leg, it's probably going to be innervated by some branch of the sciatic nerve. For example, here I believe this is the branch that extends to the membranosus and then the biceps femoris. Those are all posterior thigh muscles. And then the sciatic nerve pretty much runs to the back of the knee, where at this point it divides into the tibial nerve and the fibular nerve. The fibular nerve going off into the side towards the fibula, and the tibial nerve sticking sort of towards the tibia. So insofar as sensation, the sciatic nerve has branches called the sural branches. So on the common fibular nerve, once that branches off, one branch is going to be the lateral sural cutaneous nerves. And then there's going to be the medial sural cutaneous nerves coming off of the fibular branch. And as you can see, these are more, a whole lot more superficial, because these are going to be sensory nerves. And this medial sural nerve is going to go all the way down and start innervating the lateral side of the foot. So you're going to get a lot of the sensation from the lateral side of your foot from the sural nerve as well. So just think of the lateral side of your lower leg. More than safe in this, sural sounds a little more like lateral, and saphenous kind of sounds like medial. So it's going to account for the sensation on the medial aspect, and the sural sounding more like lateral is going to account for a lot of sensation on the lateral, more lateral aspects of your leg. What about the sensation on the top and bottom of your foot? Well, what you're going to find is that sensation on the top and bottom of your foot are going to come from extensions of the fibular nerve and the tibial nerve respectively. So the tibial nerve is going to be back here. And it's going to branch into the nerves, the cutaneous nerves of the bottom of your foot, as opposed to the top of your foot, which is going to be governed by the superficial fibular nerve. So the superficial fibular nerve up here is going to branch off and provide most of the sensations for the top of your foot. And then for the lateral side of your leg, you're going to see the sural nerve, and then the saphenous nerve is going to appear on the medial side, giving you more sensation on the medial side of your leg.